And as you can tell by the title, we are going to let you guys get to know us. So this is going to be a how we met video. So I asked you guys to give me some questions to answer off of Instagram. And today that's what we're kind of going to do. So let's get straight into it. The first question is, how did y'all meet? So you can answer first. And I'm going to see if your story matched my
story. I was homeless. All right, let's cut straight to it. The flood happened in 2016 in BR, Baton Rouge.
As it floods, as always.
And I went to every apartment complex to try to...
tell people where I used to work at.
I wasn't going to tell them where you used to work
ahead.
At.
Go ahead.
Hooters.
Boy, if you don't... Anyway, so,
no, I went to every not. Apartment complex. And... I ended up, after like the fourth one, I went into a certain apartment complex, Hooters. And that's what she's seeing me at. Nah, we're going to be real here.
Okay, go ahead. Okay. I'm listening.
Somebody else tried to shoot their shot.
Oh!
And somebody had swooped in. And we actually started off as a conversation that lasted way longer than my application for the apartment.
Like 15, 20 minutes.
We like just sitting there for 2 hour.
Okay, like all right, hour. Like an hour. It was like an hour. It was an hour.
And
I was supposed to be working, but I wasn't working.
She wasn't working. We was just having conversation about anything. And so I left, right? No phone numbers exchanged, nothing. You know, I just, you know, because I was like, okay, I got to get me straight. Let me go, you know, look in the apartment and stuff. Sure enough, I get a call. And who else was it? It was Nicole. Well, ask me. Now, she the one that gave me the keys. It was like, I was just calling to see if you got the keys or whatever. And I'm like,
you gotta shoot your shot. You can't escape.
What? You got my keys. You hand me the keys. But, you know, I'm like, oh,
just
yeah.
Just go with it, you know?
Yeah. I'm like, yeah, I got the keys. And, you know, we laughing the whole time. And she said something about you was going to cook.
No, I think I asked you what you like to eat or what you was going to eat.
And he was like, you was going to cook.
Yeah, and I was going
to
cook.
I was like,
yeah.
Oh, I'm going to get me something. You know, I'm going to have to come try me some food or whatever. She's like, well, you going to need my number for that.
Shoot your shots. Shoot your shots.
And
I already had the number. I just had to get the permission so I wouldn't just feel like stuck or something. So,
yeah,
Gotta ask last.
It was unique though.
It was cute.
And this is 2016, so it was before the hot girl summer.
Ain't no hot girl summer this way.
No, I know, but if it would have happened in hot girl summer, I'd be like, nah. You know, like, No, don't trust that.
Whatever. Next one, where are y'all from? Well, the story was 100% true, so that's how we met.
But you gotta prove my story like I was lying.
Yeah, because you know, you take stuff out, put stuff in.
Oh, no.
Okay, next one. Where are y'all from? I am from Baton Rouge, unfortunately. Derek. As most people would say. You never heard that?
Well, I'm not from, I don't know. I'm from 3 different places.
No, you're not.
I'm not?
No.
Okay, I was born in New Orleans.
Right.
Moved to Kenner, Louisiana.
That's all the same thing.
Can the people in New Orleans, people that's watching this, they'll know.
That's all we don't look at. New Orleans is New Orleans. You gotta drive across all that water to get to where. You gotta drive across all that water just to get to it. So regardless, you're still from New Orleans. Okay, so next question. How long have y'all been together? 2016, 2017. No, so do you count 2016? Or you just go straight to 2017?
It should say if we made it official. How long we been messing with each other is different from how long we actually became a couple.
So 2016, and then we actually became a couple in what?
What would you count it?
I guess 2017, because that was, no. Yeah, it was August, so it was definitely 2017. How many more kids do y'all want? We already got 50-11, so we can't do no more. That's a wrap.
That's it.
What made y'all create a YouTube channel? I don't know. I just felt like I sit at home all day. Well, I ain't gonna say sit at home all day, but I'm gonna stay at home.
You had it right the first time.
Why you always gotta edit my story? Okay, I'm a stay at home mom, so I was like, why not, you know, show people what I do. I like to do hair. Like, I do my mother-in-law hair all the time. I do his hair. All the kids' hair. So it's kind of like, I might as well just record myself doing it and show other people how to actually do it that don't really know how to do it. But for him, he was just like, I was like, yeah, you gonna do it with me, so you don't have no choice, so...
I make guest appearances like Sinead and Martin.
Crazy. Okay? Cole, you don't knock on people's door like that. That is disrespectful.
Alright? I knew you lied. Next question. What's your favorite thing about each other? Babe, you go first.
It's PG.
No.
It's not PG?
No.
So I can see.
No, you can't say that.
So it's PG.
The PG, yeah.
Oh my God.
Wow. The best thing, like, about
PG.
Her. I know, I'm about to keep it PG.
Okay.
All right. Let me edit it.
You can use
She's actually the stronger one in the relationship.
Come look at this. Look at this. Somebody come and look at this. Look at this.
Relationship. Boys. Relationship. Everything else I kill them.
Like what?
Like everything.
I'm listening. Give me one example.
Everything.
I'm listening. Give me one example.
Everything. Okay. Boys, just staying together though, you got it. You got it for the strength, but everything else, I'm like.
Yeah, pastor say, till death do you part, unless you feel like dying. I just don't know what to say.
Kill me. No. but everything.
Okay. I would say everything. Okay, no, my turn.
Everything!
So, let's see. What's the question?
She forgot the question. Everything. I would have remembered the question.
Oh, what do y'all like about each other? I would say, I don't know, it's like, you know, your personality.
Wait a minute. First of all, you're not going to speed past that like you didn't just say what you just said.
The first thing you say was you don't know.
Because it's a lot of things and I can't say.
Oh,
you
yeah,
know.
Go ahead.
Okay, he romantic when he want to be. I'm going to insert that video below so y'all can see that if y'all don't follow me on Instagram. When you want to be.
Go to Instagram.
Oh, below. It's fun. Oh, he fun. His personality is kind of 50-50. So one day you might get Hellboy, and then this day you might get the angel from Son of Anarchy. I don't know. It's just two different people. It's like two different people. I don't know. Yeah, so I'm going to just go with your personality.
Please.
No, I'm going to just go with your personality. I can't say what I really want to say.
No, don't.
Okay, so how is it having two babies under the age of two? Ooh, sis. Hey, what you going to say?
Help me, nigga.
If I could cry on cue, I would. But honestly, one of them, they opposite. They're not
it's even, like day and night.
One of them energetic, fun, bad. You break a sweat, which is my daughter. And the youngest one, he's chill unless he's hungry. But most of the part, he just chill and he laugh a lot. The oldest
yeah,
one
very
don't
goofy like me.
Don't really laugh much.
No, she's very
she's
mean.
Business.
Yeah,
she get her personality from her mama.
No. What? She act just like you. She don't act like me.
She's such
if you say something she don't like, or if you sneeze too many times around her, she gonna mug you. She gonna mush you in your face if you're too close to her face.
She is so sweet.
She don't like
her
you to kiss on
her.
No. If she don't like you to kiss her, I mean, she just not a friendly vibe. Like, she not a friendly person. Like, she just
to outside.
She just don't mess with
us.
People. certain people she mess with, like, it'll take time. But, like, a lot of people be trying to bribe her, oh, because she chunky. We just going to give you food, and you going to like us. Like, no, she not all right.
My baby not chunky.
She is chunky. So, how do you guys maintain a regular life? We don't.
At all. It's not regular.
It's just work. Well, he go to work, go to the gym, come home, play the game. You niggas
can't. How you maintain a regular? What's a regular life?
What's a regular life? I don't know. I guess we do go, like, we do find time for ourselves sometimes. Like, maybe once a month, we try to get rid of all 50, 11 of our kids and go on dates.
I'd be like twice a month we go on a date.
Yeah.
Before, if
a good movie out, then yeah, we'll go out. But yeah. Other than that, like, we don't do clubs. Because, like, in BR, it's just ratchet and there's no really good club to go to out here. But, like, when we do go out, we'll go to, like, New Orleans. Or if we plan a vacation, like, we'll go to the beach and stuff like that. Other than that, it's nothing.
What's
the
regular life?
I don't know what the regular life is either. It's like, once you...
I tell you what, marriage hard.
It is.
That's regular, how we maintain a regular life. I mean... Just, go with the flow.
It's very different.
We don't plan nothing.
Like, well, we'll plan a vacation like a week or two.
Life.
What?
No
what
plan life.
No, you just go.
We got goals.
A lot of goals. Especially business goals.
I guess.
Okay, I don't really want to tell people.
I know. I'm about to say, you'll see if you keep watching.
Yeah. Just stay tuned and you'll get to know.
Got something popping.
Okay, so how do y'all juggle business and kids? It gotta be 25-75. Because, like, you can't put more into your business that you put into the kids. Because then you're just going to be a horrible parent. I'm sorry to tell you like that. But, yeah, you can't
do
that.
Worst thing is people don't know they're horrible parents. But
it is what it is. But, okay, so basically it's like we try to take the kids out at least. I don't know. It just depends on how they act. Like, or if everybody on the same schedule that week, we'll be like, okay, we ain't tired. So we're just going to take the kids to the zoo. Or we'll go to the aquarium. Or we'll just go, you know, to my in-laws. Oh, they like to do experiments. Yeah, experiments. They just did their little volcano and coke thing recently. And I ain't know they had even did it. So, I don't know. It's just, you just got to have fun with the kids.
It depends on the age groups. Anybody below the age of 10, it's not hard to entertain.
No, not at all. Especially our youngest kids. You just throw a ball in there. They're like, ooh, it's a ball. I don't know.
Poor furniture.
Oh.
You have to say about sex life?
No. Oh, I talk about sex life.
If the people want to know, I would like to know too.
I mean, you get it when it fit in. Like, okay, no, let me say my point. So, I had two kids back to back. So it's kind of like, ladies, y'all know it's different. Like your body change, your hormones change, your attitude change, your mood swings change, everything changed. So it's kind of like now you got to adjust to their schedule, adjust to his schedule, adjust to your own schedule. Adjust to your own schedule. And, yeah, you just do when you can. What you got to say?
When you can.
Yeah.
When you can is every day. Listen, fellas, what ladies don't understand. Okay, if you got enough time to scroll on Instagram, scroll over all these little websites and all this other, you got time to walk. In the bath, you don't even have to do it in the bed. Sometimes.
PG-13.
Anyway, it don't always have to be in a bed setting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Sometimes in the wash and dry, it's just perfectly fine. All right. And it's exotic. And you do not make that feel. All right. You have to be open minded.
We got kids that know how to open doors, lock doors, climb my windows.
Do we have bedtimes? Do we have, me and you have bedtimes?
No.
No. But the kids do.
Kids are nosy as well. Especially our older kids, they are very nosy.
Oh, they super nosy. We'll make it more fun, so now we gotta be secret agents when we do it. Huh? Dun dun!
Okay, so how do we find, like, time for, like, romantic stuff? Like, what you did yesterday? Like, how do we find time for stuff like that? Because I'm nosy as hell, I'm gonna tell you that.
It's always.
It's like, if I go... like an hour, okay, he texts me and I ignore it and I go an hour because I'm trying to hurry up and do stuff. He be like, oh, what you doing? You not asleep? Blah, blah, blah. So how do you find time to do romantic stuff? I'm just saying, like, if I'm trying to do something for you and I'm running, or I'm trying to sit up, like, how do you
make it not seem
you make it not seem suspicious to where it's a surprise?
I do. This is what I do. Now, everybody not cool with the... No, I don't.
So you didn't get that idea from me? I did that first. Numerous times.
You did it first. Okay. But how I did it was way more, you know.
Yeah, it was unexpected.
She broke in my apartment the first time.
Oh!
That should be a story.
Well, tell your story then.
No, I just walked in.
I'm going to just say this. It was like, I don't know if we was fussing. No, I don't think it was fussing. No, I think he just kept complaining about work and how one of his coworkers was just egging his nerves. I shouldn't say that, huh?
No, you just keep it G.
Oh, he was egging his nerves. I was like, okay, let me find something to calm him down. So me and my friend went to the store, and I got like 2-3 dozens of roses. I got some candles, some tea light candles, just something simple. And I think that was it, right?
And you broke in my apartment.
No, that was the second time. I'm talking about the second time when I put the stuff like on the rug and stuff.
Oh.
Yeah, I just put the roses and candles and stuff. That was the second time I broke into this apartment. The first time before we started living together was for his birthday. So it was lit.
Imagine you walking in your apartment and look like somebody about to sacrifice. Candles lit in a circle.
It was
started
cute.
To turn around.
No,
it was cute. Damn, in the wrong apartment.
Okay. So when you walk through the door, I think I got a video. If I do, I'll just, put that right there so y'all can see it. So look, you walk into the apartment, right? You got rose petals that start at the doorway. That's fire from the beginning. So you got the rose petals that go all the way to the room. On side of the road, like, the rose petals is in, like, a walkway. And then on side of them, it's like the candles was lit all the way to the room. Get in the room, we got balloons, like, all in the ceiling. It was cute. And then it had a gift. On the bed with a handwritten note on side of it. Handwritten note. I ain't buy it from Dollar Tree, Family Dollar, Walmart. I took cardstock paper, sis. Not no regular degular, paper. Cardstock paper, and I wrote a whole paragraph.
It sounded like acrimony.
That was not like acrimony. That was not like acrimony. And that movie didn't even come out then.
That's
what
I'm saying. Think about it.
That was 2016.
I
should have
known it.
No, no.
I should have known it.
I wasn't breaking the internet or nothing. I was just...
That was breaking the internet. I didn't give her no key. She didn't tell me she was coming.
That was the whole... It's a surprise. You can't be like, oh, yeah, look.
A surprise?
Look, check this out.
Is what
I
did.
I'm going to go to the office. I'm going to get your key, right? That was the perks of working at an apartment complex.
Listen, it's a way to do this. All you had to do was a month ahead.
Okay, I'm listening.
You know, would you be tripping if you walked in there? And
I don't want to tell you.
And no, it ain't got to be. It's just like, what if you walk in and boom... I'm there with a gift or something, a surprise for you. A man gonna automatically think, oh snap, she gonna be in some lingerie on the bed. And if I'd be like, yeah, that's cool. But it never happened. But next month, that's what you do. I wouldn't have trouble. I'm like, damn, Jay told her, I just opened the door. I seen candles.
I was like, okay, I never did this before. So let me
move in my apartment.
No. So I was like, let me try this. I never did this before, so I'm gonna try it. And I did it. You liked it. You cried. If y'all get... So you remember sniffing in the beginning of that video?
No.
Play it back. Play it back. Because now you got amnesia. So you wasn't sniffing.
I didn't see this video.
So I walk in. And this is what she did.
So you
hear
that?
Where's the crying? No.
Don't be in denial.
I miss them slippers.
Them thigh slippers. Look at them balloons.
What a note.
Oh, you really did have a
note. Yeah, see? Damn, some of my...
I didn't cry. Had. You know what that note is. So... And you better not edit that part.
I
was not crying like
video.
I said.
You was sniffing a little bit.
I wasn't even sniffing. You didn't even...
Y'all, it's just horrible. So, who is the most outspoken of the two of y'all?
Me.
Why you say you?
Because I never played that. I always speak your mind. That's how I was taught. And then on the other side of life, I was taught, you don't like it, do something.
The boo. You hear me? Okay.
But I turn it off in restaurants. She turns it on.
No. If your food is not right, let me tell you. If you're paying for something, look, I'm going to just pay for something that I know I'm not going to eat. To me, that's crazy. If they bring you the wrong food or your steak not cooked all the way, I had that happen to me before. I'm pregnant. You're not supposed to eat undone meat. So I was like, you know, I want my stuff well done.
I never seen nobody cut a steak so fast before the waitress walk off.
I said, ma'am, hold on. Here you go, ma'am. I said, ma'am. This steak. Here it is. I said, no, ma'am, this too pink. I can't do this. Oh, well, ma'am, man. I'll take it back. So I feel like once you cut a steak, that need to go in the trash. They don't need to put that cut up steak back on the grill to cook it.
They tried to play one time. They
tried to play me. So I was like.
I saw expertise. She's like, uh-uh. Look at this knife cut. This is the same steak.
It's the same steak. Like, I said, no, I don't want it.
I'm like, just please, no.
He swear every time. Oh, you send food back or you got a problem with your order. Somebody going to spit in your cup or somebody going to spit in your food. No.
She give it to them all in the drive-thru.
I'll be like, oh, no, my fries cold. And I hand the bag back.
I'm not eating that.
And he be like, well, I'm not eating it. I don't want nothing. I'm like, okay.
I'll stop till I get home. Y'all ain't about to play with my food. Mm-mm. You don't mind?
No, because I'm not paying $30. Okay, we went to sell grass. Let's take this way. We deduct tips.
We started you off
at a high level.
At a high level.
If you coming back too slow with the drinks, $2 off. If your fork and your knife dirty, another $2 off. Now you at $6. I don't know what to tell you.
I'll tell you. Then you bring that steak back.
The steak pink knife. Nah, don't put that on my towel. I'm telling you, I'm gonna cut up.
She did that one time. You did that too.
They really
didn't put it on a receipt.
I'm not paying for that. If I didn't eat it, like, what you judge me for?
That's the only time I get nervous is when we have to go to restaurants. I be like, Lord, please let us get a good waitress.
When we go, and he always had problems when we go to the movies because he said I don't have a movie voice. So he feel like I'm disrupting everybody else.
I got this segment. Oh, I got this. People that watch movies, we all know when we go in a movie theater, we develop a movie voice. All right? So, you know, I can, don't even hear. Man, I'm sitting there watching a movie. What is it, like our first date? That's when I knew.
To be fair, I was drunk. So when you're drunk or intoxicated, as you would say, it was just all over. And you was laughing too. You was like, shh, man, be quiet.
I was like, believe, oh, okay. Bang! Bang! Hey! Hey! Hey, who's that? I'm like,
I know.
Like, oh, man, you know you scooped down in your chair by looking back? I was like, Lord, please don't do a shh. Cause this is like, it's like a disrespect in the movie.
That's it for me. Now I'm about to just turn the whole place, just flip it upside down.
What you want to do?
What happened? We sat at the bar for a good 30 minutes because we was like an hour before the movie. So, you know, at Movie Tavern, they got the bar, the open bar or bar, whatever. And I was like, oh, that drink look good. So the girl just kept coming back, like refilling it. So at this point, we had $50 on our tab.
I don't know how we made it to the movie, to the room.
Oh, no, the people came out, was like, last call for such and such movie. And we was like, that's our movie. So I was like, you know, let's just go sit down in the movie. Ooh. The lights were still on because they give you like a little time to, you know, look at your menu or not. And I was like, oh, okay, I'm loud. And then I don't know. After him, I was like, I got that video too. He was like, hey, Be quiet. It was just horrible. The next day, we just laughed at it. Oh, so how about you tell them about our first date?
We went to the movies.
I know, but who asked? Was it me or was it you? Did I ask you on a date or did you ask me on a date? I can't remember.
I can't remember neither.
We didn't see so many movies since we've been together. I don't even remember what we saw.
No, but this is definitely going to blemish our relationship great. We don't remember our first movie. We don't remember who asked who on a date.
Dang, I really don't remember what it was.
Oh, you know what? All right. It's coming back to me.
How?
I think you was like, we should go out.
Yeah, I was like.
Because you had a babysitter.
Right.
And I'm like, cool, we can go out. But I picked the movies to go out.
Yeah, because I was like, I'm not really into movies, but we can go to the movies anyways.
Yeah, that's
so how it was went. The movie.
It was the movie. Now, what movie we seen? I have no idea.
We have seen like 50,000 movies since we've been together.
A lot of movies. I'm a movie head.
Yeah, he's a movie freak. I just watch and then get lost the first 30 minutes of the movie and be loud and just be like, what they talking about?
Some movies
except for like Avengers and stuff. I'll ask you afterwards because I don't want to really be rude because I know you like Avengers and stuff. So
yeah, that's one person. If it ain't God, don't talk to me during the Avengers movie.
Eventually he gonna buy it, like, at home. Like, he like to buy movies to keep it on TV. So I know eventually he gonna buy it, so I could just, like, backtrack. But social media kills all movies. Like, if they got a movie social coming media out,
sometimes kills relationships too.
That too, but we're gonna get to the movie first. So first, it's like, when you know a movie coming out, don't get on Instagram, don't get on Twitter, Avengers, yeah, and it was like such and such died, and I said, like, I don't even want to see the movie no more. And he was like, you still gotta see the movie? I'm like, okay. So how do you feel? Social media kills relationships.
I didn't know you was about to really go into that.
Yeah, I really
me personally, I don't think y'all should be following each other.
I think you should.
I think it just costs too much.
I honestly feel like this. People put too much into relationship and social media. It's like, this person get mad. Like, I'm not that type of person. Like, oh, you ain't post me on Wednesday. Oh, what, you got somebody new? I'm not like that. So I call you on Wednesday or text you on Wednesday, be like, oh, why you ain't post me?
Not on Wednesday. Just Monday through Friday.
Why are you lying?
Oh, so you took me off your profile picture.
No, when he get mad, let me tell you. My picture already been up there just because. So when he get mad, he be like, delete, or archive, however it go. I know I archive. Because you can, like, bounce it back and be like, oh, yeah, it's been on there. I ain't delete nothing. No, we don't do that over here. Because guess what? If that count at the top on Instagram ain't 7 and it's 1, so you delete it. Let me tell you, you gone. Because that one bitch is going to be a your child, or it's going to be a funny video, or it's going to be something that ain't got to do with you. So, yeah, be mad then. True?
That is true.
I honestly feel like, as far as, like, social media and stuff, like, if you mad or if, like, y'all in a relationship and y'all going through stuff,
delete
you shouldn't put... No, that's not what I was about to say.
Delete her. I don't want
that's to. Not, that's not what I was about to say.
Go ahead.
I was about to say, you shouldn't, like, put, oh, I'm tired of this, loyalty, blah, blah, blah. Like, you shouldn't put your relationship problem on social media, because I feel like that's not between you and however many followers you have. You have 1,000, 1.K, whatever you at. Like, everybody in the world should know your problems. That should be something between y'all. Agree.
Now, what do you tell the people that don't have nobody to talk to? Say you couldn't talk to your spouse.
Mm-hmm.
They never listen.
Talk to your homeboy.
I'm
not a fan. Nope. Let me just shut this down right now for everybody. Be like, oh, I seen this recently on Facebook. Do you feel like your man should have a female friend? No. Because I feel like I don't want a male friend, so why should you have a female friend? It's not like insecurity. It's just like, that's just cold. Like that's just cold. Like, what you going to talk to another female for? Like, you got a female at home. Talk to your female at home.
But I was going to say, what if your female at home don't
talk? Talk to your bros. Like, okay, I feel like... No, you have good friends. You have good friends.
I think I only have, like, one bad friend out the 5. Okay. One keep it G.
He does. Yeah, he does. He's like, well, I feel... Yeah, I like him. You know. But some of your friends is kind of like, they borderline. Ooh. Well, no, I ain't going to say that. Out of your 4 friends that you have, out of your 5 friends that you have, I really like everybody, you know. They supportive. Like, if your friends can't support you and your relationship, then that's just not your friend. Didn't you just say something about that?
Mm-hmm.
What it was?
That's what you just said.
What? If your friends trying to...
Oh, you talking about recently?
Yeah.
But I was like, if your friends get mad because you hang around your girl too much, it's probably because they want your spot. They want your girl spot. Dudes just be too close. I don't see why y'all want to hang around a group of dudes all day.
I can't.
I don't know. I like to... You don't want to smell hard legs all day. I mean, I'm just...
What's hard legs? What they mean?
Man legs. Muscles.
I mean, they got women out here with man legs, too. Look at me. Never mind.
Yeah. We ain't even going to touch that one. you would not be able to host the Grammys.
No, ma'am. Hang it up. No, you too few. I don't know. I just feel like you do more with your spouse than you do with other people. Like, I have a best friend, don't get me wrong, but, you know, she do stuff with her man, her kids. I do stuff with... my kids and my man. look like that. Or she probably doing hair somewhere.
The world changed.
Oh, working.
The world changed. This used to be about getting married. And having, and having a family, you know, and with your wife, and then, you know, double dating. But now it's like, you know, man, you don't need a female, man. Come out here, get this money with us men. Then we're going to go to the club with us men.
Smell like musk all day.
That is horrible, man.
I don't know. Like, what's your favorite thing to do that we do as a couple?
Drink. I love when we drink. Oh, the mistakes that get made.
Yeah, that's why we got two mistakes that should be made. Well, no. Our first child was on purpose. That first
one was super on purpose.
She was on purpose.
Extra purpose. That's why she looked like
him. And she came out just like him. That's why I just don't do nothing with have kids.
Now, the second one.
It's kind of like he borderline.
Borderline what?
Like, he have features of yours. But he mostly have features on mine.
I was talking about if we did it on purpose. I think we just wasn't can. We didn't think. Honestly, just wasn't educated about how long it takes after a pregnancy to get pregnant.
Yeah, I thought it was going to happen that fast. And it was kind of like, boop, there you go.
Fellas, give them 6 weeks after the pregnancy and then give them another 6 weeks. Stay super. Man. Whew.
Let's say 4 to 6 months. How about that? When did your child at least to the halfway mark?
How many times a week should a married couple be intimate? Since I can't use the...
I feel like at least 3. I mean... What? Okay, no. Okay, I'm going to put it like this. It depends. Like, if you're doing one time, 2 times a day, or 3 times a day, multiply that. If you're doing it 2-3 times a day.
So that's never heard, that haven't been heard of?
I mean, yeah, it's been heard of, but I feel like, you know, you gotta, you can't just.
Okay, so 3 times a week. Now, is we talking Monday through Sunday or Monday through Friday?
Ooh. I mean, what you consider as a week, Monday through Friday?
Monday through Friday. And then Saturday. And
Saturday, Sunday is extra.
It's just up game.
Yeah, so three. Come on now, that's Monday, Wednesday, Friday. You don't agree?
Yeah.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I mean, what if you do
Monday,
two?
Wednesday, Friday?
I mean, if you do like two a day.
Monday through Friday.
2 a days or one a day, whatever.
One a day is being generous.
Very generous.
But, you know, sometimes, you know, you gotta, her body can't take all that draining. You gotta have Gatorade next to the bed, respirator.
Boy, if you don't...
You gotta be CPR certified. All type of stuff.
I know you're lying.
Woo! I mean, that's... You know, I guess it depends on the dude. Me. Okay, this is how I look at it.
Okay.
If your man just can't keep his hands off you. Listen. Right? And I ain't talking Bill Cosby way. But can't keep your hands off you. That's saying... Okay, maybe he only wants you. You know what I'm saying? If your man come home every now and then, he got a side chick. Y'all can be in denial all y'all want. I'm telling you what it is.
Ain't the kids over here, but I'm just saying.
Huh?
You just speaking in general, right?
Oh, you think I'm talking about me?
No, you're not talking about you. I'm just saying. You're just giving them. You're just giving them some thought.
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead.
What?
I'm just saying
for
somebody. Oh, he got a
side. Just man. Oh, I'm gonna get my more three times a week. 3 times a week is pathetic, man. Y'all gotta step it up. Now some people like can't handle it. I mean, yeah.
Okay, so what would be your favorite thing about being in a long term relationship? Like, what's like, I don't know. Like, do you agree with people that like stay in long term relationships and then just don't have nothing going for the relationship? Like,
nope.
They stop going out and stuff like that. Like,
it don't start with they stop going out.
What does it start with?
It start with some communication. Once they stop communicating, mm-hmm. everything goes downhill. So once you stop communicating, Why would you want to go out with a person you don't even know anymore? Why would you want to sleep with a person you don't even know? So, I mean, once you lose communication and interest, and when I say by interest, mean you don't even care if it get fixed or not. So, long-term relationships can be good and bad. Sometimes you're in a relationship that isn't going anywhere, the more you hurting yourself, you're hurting your kids, you know. And by the time you realize it's time to leave, you have nothing of yourself to give to the next person that's probably ready to step up. Could be good because you learn as you go, which I'm finding out in marriage. You know, you ask an older couple, like, that been married 30 years, right. Oh, you know, how y'all made it work? And she be like, girl, praying, trying not to kill him.
You sound like your mom, right? Because that was her answer when we asked her. She was like, yeah, girl, you got to pray.
That's all she said. You don't know what that means, but, you know, because on the outside, it looked like they just
were perfect. The perfect couple, but, you know, a lot of people, well, everybody goes through stuff, and it's kind of like, it's just patience.
I don't think people should go through the same stuff. That's my problem. You going through the same stuff?
I mean, honestly, it's the same stuff. Okay, I feel like this. If a relationship not 50-50.
What's 50-50? People might think you're talking about a lottery ticket. What's 50-50?
No, like, if you give me 50%, if you give me your 100%, I'm giving my 100%, and we meet each other halfway, like, with pretty much everything.
That's expecting somebody to be perfect, though. What if a person don't have 50% to give? They're damaged, so all they have is 25.
I mean, it's all about the next person. Like, if you feel like working with that person, or you feel like, you know, it's somebody that you want to...
You want to... What? I'm not... What?
You want to... You know, yeah, for the rest of your life, then okay.
That's true. Say be intimate.
Yo, yeah, be intimate. I mean, I don't know. Like, I don't speak code. Like, well, I'm just as great. Like, it just come out. And I be trying not to.
That makes sense. That's another big part. Can you be intimate with that person for the rest of your life? What if you live to, like, 80? And then God mess around and be like, I'm going to make her live to 82.
Come on, God. I know you lying. Oh, man. Oh, that's messed up. We're so messed up. What made you say that?
Oh, it is a long time. A chick to be giving you that headache, man. You know that headache you get right here when they get on your nerves. See, man, rub that. 80 years old, your piece of your head has been.
I know you lie.
I got to make my head drop out again. God damn.
Okay, so that concludes this video. Make sure you guys are subscribed to our channel. Comment anything that you want to see us do for the next video in the comment box. Be sure to like the video. Also, you can follow us on social media. It's going to be like in the description box below. And yeah, that concludes.